VR case gaming controller on this episode of My Tiny Point of View. Now, I'd like to first take the time to apologize for such a long stretch in between My Tiny Point of View videos. I unfortunately don't have a presentable place to record, and there's all these distractions around me. Plus, my computer is horrible at rendering video. It takes forever. Now, if you remember correctly, on an episode of Unbox It here on the WeDeem channel, I unboxed three different cheap VR headsets. Now, naturally, I wanted a controller to play. Now, I had two other controllers I tried to connect. It didn't really work all that well, so I decided to hunt down a VR controller. Now, there's many of them, many traditional controllers, but I liked the VR case and the way it looks. So I decided to go by looks purely alone. And when I got this controller, it came in a box like this, which is pretty plain, but I like the overall design of this box. And inside the box, you got your Chinese manual, which of course is in English, but it's not very easy to understand. Then you got the controller. When you put it in your hands, batteries out, it feels extremely light and cheap. Now you have your thumbstick, your trigger buttons, your action buttons, then you got the power button and an at button, which apparently changes the layout of gameplay. Now if you hit at and B, you get game mode, which I believe you play like this, like a traditional controller. If you hit at and C, you get the VR mode, which you hold it like this, which is the reason why I purchased this controller. Now, when I first tried to turn this on, the controller would not come on. I shortly realized I got a damaged one. The springs were bent, so the battery was not sitting in there correctly. So I had to fiddle with it, finally got it on. The indicator light blinked, and then it shut off. Now, let me tell you, that indicator light is a pinhole. It sucks. It's horrible. Now, once it blinks and goes off, you don't know if the controller's on until your phone connects to Bluetooth. I did get it to play with VR Zombies one time. Now, for some reason, this controller is not responsive at all. It was hitting the trigger buttons, but the trigger button, but not always. And while I decided to record this video, it wouldn't work, period. I could not get the trigger button to work. The only thing that would work is I would hit the thumbstick and it would raise the volume. Then I would hit one of the action buttons and it would shut the game off completely. This controller is completely frustrating, not worth your time. I paid $10 for it. I definitely feel like I got robbed. If you want to try the controller out, I don't know why, but if you do, I wouldn't pay any more than $5. Because at least then, it's $5. Let's throw this piece of crap away. Don't buy it. But if you want to buy it, if you want to try it out for yourself, I'll leave a link in the description down below. Now, before I conclude this video, I'd like to take the time to discuss the Nyko PlayPad Pro. Now this overall is a way better controller. Now unfortunately I can't show any video because I have since passed the controller on to someone else, but I will try to describe it as best as I can. The controller itself is laid out just like the Xbox 360 controller, which in my opinion is one of the best controllers ever made, and due to the fact that people like to imitate it, it proves that fact. It has your diagonal analog sticks, your action button, your trigger and bumper buttons, your D-pad, and your home and a start button. Now, I bought it specifically for my tablet a while back. That was probably about a year or two ago, to play Shadowgun. And it works extremely well. It's extremely responsive. It has its own software for customizing the buttons. And it supports Android 3.0 and up. Now, I don't know if it really works with PC because I think I tried to connect to it one time and didn't really get it to work. It might, I don't know. But overall, the Nyko PlayPad Pro gaming controller, Bluetooth gaming controller, is definitely worth your time, unlike the VR case. If you're looking for an affordable gaming controller, I think I got it for $15. I sold it for $5, so you might be able to get it really cheap. I definitely check it out. If you have any questions about either controller showcased on this episode of My Tiny Point of View, please leave them in the comments down below. And as always, thank you for watching another episode of My Tiny Point of View. Please hit the like and subscribe button if you'd like to see more from the WeeDean channel.